Hi everyone, really excited today. We're going to be trialing out SKATER XL. It's a new game coming to PlayStation and Xbox, I think, in about mid-June. It has early access available on the computer, which it's just like demo stuff. It's not going to be the full-length game or anything like that. But we're going to try out a few of the levels, see if we can get the tricks sorted out and see how we can like learn the controls, because it is a little bit different. So stay tuned and we'll check out SKATER XL. Let's go ahead and get in. Here we go. Alright. How do we do this now? Oh no, this is not like... Oh jeez, what have I done? This is not like skate at all. Just hang on. You gotta press X to A to go. And then left stick up. Okay. So I can do nollies. Is it inverted? Oh, okay. Nolly pop shove it. Oh. Okay, hang on a second. What do we do? No. Alright. Alright, now we gotta work out how to do something that's not a nolly related trick. Hang on. Okay, so right thumbstick for. Oh, hang on. Okay, so left thumbstick is left foot, right thumbstick is right foot. Okay, that makes sense. But does that mean if I... so you get a... Okay. It's somewhat similar to... somewhat similar to skate, in the sense that you got to use the thumbsticks to control, but definitely a little different. Let's see if I can get some music pumping, actually. I don't know if this game has any music. It's a Spotify skate tracks. Skater vibes. This is Spotify track list, skater vibes. Okay, we got a kickflip going. See if I can do it. I'm gonna slide down the barrier there. Alright, let's see if we can do the... I don't think I'm gonna get this. Alright, I'm doing a fakie pop shove it. Okay. Okay. The controls are interesting. I think that's going to be the hardest thing for people to get used to with this game. It's incredibly different. Like, it's not something you've used before in any sort of like of the Tony Hawk games or skate games. It's very similar to skate in the sense that you use the thumbstick, but you're using more than just the singular thumbstick, because in skate you use the one and it was much easier. But with this one, your left foot and front foot, left and right feet are controlled separately. So, we can manual, and you can, okay, so we can make some good lines. Yeah, so you gotta use your left thumbstick to do a nose manual, and to do a normal manual is right thumbstick. Okay, interesting. Let's see if we can ollie and manual. Up it, couldn't get the height. go. What's down here? Nothing. Ah! Went through the barrier. Okay. I'm going to master this control system. I must. I've just fall through the world. Alright, we're going to do a grind. We're going to grind. Ah! Come on! I must have to press something to grind. Oh. Okay. Hang on, let's check out the controls menu. Hang on. Maps. California Skate Park Beta. I've seen other people play on this big mega ramp. I want to go there, that looks sick. What have we got here? This looks like a Santa Monica Boulevard sort of vibe here. Oh, hang on. Car park. My natural instinct is to use the right thumbstick a lot more and just the left to turn. So I'm only doing like right thumbstick related tricks. Oh, we did a grind finally. Oh, that was a switch feeble. What was that? Now, how do we grab? Can we do grab tricks? Okay, so the right bumper does, I'm guessing, left bumper, left hand. Yep. Okay. Okay. Hey, we're getting better at the controls here. Ooh. I don't even know what happened there. Okay. I'm hitting the desk with the controller. It's making me do the grab. Fix up something over here, just 1 second. Somehow exited the game. Don't want to do that again. Okay, let's see if I can just move this. I cannot move that. Back in. All right, so let's work out how maps gear burgundy. Woody, light blue, okay. Go there, black with a tan, I like that, that looks, hang on, I'll change that hat looks ridiculous. Do we have to have a hat? There's just no option for no hat, okay. So, yeah, we go for the classic black and white sole. I guess that's what we're doing. Maps. Official maps. Custom maps. To install user-created mod maps, please place the file. Okay, so we're gonna go check out Discord for some more maps. That'd be cool. See what the community's making already. I know with the re-release of the new Tony Hawk game's gonna have some pretty sick editing. One of the biggest things in that game was even though at the time it was pretty basic comparably, but it was just one of the funnest things just to make like some stupid big map that was just perfect for a trick run, get that massive high score. Okay, one of the things I can't get is how to slow down exactly. Like, oh, we can fakie push. Okay, oh, not fakie, what's it called? Goofy, that's it. Oof. I really want to slide down this barrier. Is this me resetting my spawn point? I set up in the wrong spot, I take it. I'm probably going to break the game in a second. Oh, he's getting long. Okay, hang on. Oh, the little white. It's the shadow of it, not the actual. Right. It's the shadow of the arrow, not where the arrow is itself. Alright, here we go. Oh, and I fucking ollied over it. Now I can ollie over things. Can't war, right? Alright. I think we're gonna have to start getting some of those community built custom maps. I wanna get the one where it's a big like Danny Way's mega ramp style. I wonder if they're gonna incorporate a story, it's just gonna be like one big open world with a couple of like side quests and more of like an online sort of community challenges and stuff. Interesting to see, because there's nothing here at the moment. There's no like other character of sorts just to sort of instruct you. It's just free roam of this two little areas. Actually, let's go back to that other one. Get some of these grab tricks sorted. Oh, I'm pressing the wrong button. That's fine. It'd be good if you can change the controls, because my instinct for grab is to use the trigger, not the bumper. So I want to change that. I would like to change that. That would be a little bit simpler for the controls, I think. You start getting used to the control though, it's quite easy to get used to. This. Oh, I can't do it. Yeah. Okay. Alright, let's go see if we can get some of these those games, where do they say to put the file? So, to install user created mod maps, place the file in documents/skaterxl/maps. Okay. So, I'm going to go check out that Discord. I'll just flick over the. Let me just flick over the camera for you guys. What we're doing here.
Wrong screen.
Where's your maps? There it is. Oh, we've got Discord, hang on. There's Discord. There we go. Here it is. Where are these maps? You must be a member for at least 10 minutes to send a message in this server. Have I joined this server? Streaming mode is enabled. Stay safe, friend. Okay. Oh, that's a couple tips. All right. Mod developer, map creator, moderator. Playing Overwatch. Map release. Here we go. Mapping assets. Map creation. It's looking really good. That does look pretty good, actually. I wonder what software they use. I think they're using Unity because the game runs. You guys can't see that, but you can see the. If you look at that little symbol next to the Skater XL, that's the game creation software Unity. I think you can get a free version of it online, like a little basic pack. But if you ever make money off it, they take a, I think a percentage or something. If you're good at sort of designing and maybe some, I think there's some coding involved as well. It'd be worth looking into, but that looks cool. They've even got the graffiti on that one. See if I can get that. Is that a, can I download that? No, that looks like it's just a YouTube video. Okay. Map beta, alpha. Some of these are really good. These are like, they've taken a lot of time. Oh, here we go. Is this so file, add them, big drop. Here we go. Here we go. Oh, the detail is great there. They've even got the little, let's bring that up. You can see they've even got the broken bits of cement. The rebar coming out, the sand. That's these guys are really good. Like, props to these guys for doing this. I imagine these people are just like hobbyists doing this. Is that gonna, one of the guys on the list over here? Hulobu? No. Okay, so how do we download these maps? That's the thing. SkateXL. Nothing here. Help. Help! Help me download stuff. Okay. Here we go, here we go, here we go. Perfect question, Blurry. I'm thinking the same thing. In hashtag maps on the left. Hashtag maps on the left. Hashtag map archive. And has anyone been able to get a shred menu? Or is it broke overall? Nah, bot is broken. Hashtag map. Same. Okay. If you're trying to download mods, hashtag beginner guides. I'm a beginner. Okay. How to add custom maps, clothing, and here we go. This is what we want, little video. once we work this out. Shout out to whoever's Twitch this is. Thanks for the content.
Hey, what's up, guys? My name is Sean. For those who follow me on Twitch, they might know me as Milky_IRL. Today we're going to be going over how to install custom maps, clothing, and skateboards in Skater XL.
Let's see if I can skip through some of this.
For this tutorial, the most important one, I guess, would be called the skin editor. You know, so prior to Skater XL modding, and the steps are as follows. You need to have the Skater XL beta, you need to have the shred menu installed, and you need to have Unity Mod Manager. So those three things. Covered that in the previous video. If you don't have that, there's links below.
Fair enough.
The different categories.
I don't think I'm going to be able to download these ones today. Gotta download all that stuff first of all. Okay. In that case, map creation, map beta. These are some really good ones. Like, if this is the kind of stuff that just like the community's creating, this game is going to be pretty awesome, I reckon. Down the link. Oh, hang on. So I just need to drag the file in. So if I just need to download this, no preview available, download. It's going to be a virus. Okay. It's going. Doing something. Okay. That's a nice one. Can I download that? Hey guys, this is my first map created for Skater XL. It's a simple map made to my liking. Well, me lucky lucky too. Bye. Me not lucky lucky, that kind of link. Media fire. Don't trust it. Okay. Show in folder. Cool. And cut that. I don't know where my, it'll be in Steam. Steam library. Steam apps. Would be good if I knew where the files were. Hang on. Let's go here. Map. Maps. Map. Search map just gets Gamma's map. I'll bring this off screen just in case it comes up with anything that people can use to get into my computer. I'm really excited for these maps that are coming out, and hopefully they continue this sort of map creator system when the game goes live in June, because being able to design and share your own maps is really cool. Hopefully it's a little bit simpler. Maybe there's like an in-game way to do it, like you can search in like a map, community map sort of menu, but for now this is still pretty cool. Okay, so my map search is finished, and I'm not getting anything specific here for Skater XL. I'm just gonna gonna change, maybe search the word skater. I wonder if this game has been like created using the content created from the early community, like the mods that have been made and the maps that have been made. Are they like sourced and then, you know, they've asked the creator, hey, we really like this. Like this one here, if this is a nighttime map and they've gone like and designed the dynamic lighting and things like that, is that something that they just ask the creator, hey, you've done a really good job here, we like that, can we pay you some money for it? Okay, so I've found what I think might be it. So I'm just gonna paste that there. I'm gonna shut down the game now. I'm gonna shut down the game now. And then I think I've just done it. So let's have a look here. Skater XL. Play. All right. Documents, Skater XL maps. Do I have to create, so documents, Skater XL maps. Maybe I've got to do that. So maybe it's not that, maybe I go cut. Do I create a folder here? Skater XL. And then maps. Do I just paste it in there? Paste. And then where's my mouse? Can't see my cursor, hang on. Hey! That's how you do it. Okay. So that is pretty easy actually. I was looking for source, like the source files. You don't need to do that at all. You just simply create a file in your own. Okay. I just jumped off the map. So you just create a file in your own documents thing and that's how it sets it up. Okay. That's so easy actually. Much easier than I was expecting. It's pretty nice. No, rails are a good height. What have we got here? Didn't even worry about putting like walls or anything for the ground. It's just full. Okay. Where am I? Drop me here. Ooh, let's see if we can work this half pipe. Nope. So Ed, you've done yourself rubber hit there. Ed, you've made yourself a good little map. I'm liking it. Ah. Oh no, sorry, Zuma. So you've made the Ed Benedict skate park Zuma. Parking curb. I like that he hasn't really gone to the extent to create the background so much, so you can see under the map, under the road here, there's like nothing there. Alright, how come I can't turn around? What's going on? Ah. Alright, let's go this way. We can go that way. Yes. Alright. Let's try and get a line set. So let's go. We're going to do a trick across. Oh, I missed the curb. Okay. Kickflip to manual. Nope. Alright. Let's try this again. So we're going to do flip trick to grind. Ah. I might do the line down this way, just because it seems to be a bit more open space. Okay. So that's cool. There's a few bugs in this because of the I guess it's not coded, or I guess like the, I'm not sure what the term would be exactly, but where normally this would go through a design process and there'll be testers and stuff like that, there's a few little parts where I guess the world doesn't connect and it sort of glitches you out. As you've seen that I've sort of flown in the middle of the air for no reason and get stuck. That's probably normal, but other times not so much. Like that. Like I shouldn't be going through that. I should be able to slide that. Why did I do a trick? Oh, ah. Alright, let's see if we can get another map. This one's cool, but it's small. I want to see if I can get like a nice big one. Maybe one with a half pipe or a bowl or something, so we can try and do some grab tricks as well. So let's go back into that Discord group. Where's that? There it is. So let's go through this Discord and let's see if we can find another one. Preferably on a Google Drive as well. I like Google Drive. I trust their files a little bit better. They're probably all the same. It's just personal preference, I think. This can't scan this for viruses. It's got no bad feedback. It wasn't deleted post, so we'll trust it. We'll trust it this time. Well, let's let that do its thing. Let's go back to the Discord again. That's nice. That's some nice. Like, getting the graffiti on there as well. Like, that is a lot of graffiti. If they had to do that themselves, that's some dedication, because it's all unique, different styles as well. Like, people who do graffiti, they generally have a style. I've got a couple of friends who used to do it when they were younger, and they would always write the same way. They would always do the same images or a similar style of image. So that's all different styles of it with the, like the lettering and whatnot. So that's some creative stuff there. Hulu Boo or Aaron Williamson. Good job. That is sick. Can I download that? Tampa. I'm gonna have to trust MediaFire. Gonna have to do it. That's store information. There are a number of different file types. Is this song? Lyric's like, I want my blood inside of you. The hell? Okay. I can't wait for the soundtrack for Tony Hawk Pro Skater 1 plus 2. Ah. Oh. Like 60% of that game was just to listen to the tracks when you were younger. Like, if you didn't have the CDs already, you could just flick on the game and you'd just be sitting there just listening to the music. Same with games like Grand Theft Auto. The soundtracks really make the game. I'm not a fan of a lot of these tracks though. Try this, got on my skateboard. Miss Teen, Massachusetts by the Skaters is the band, okay. Oh yeah, artists. Yeah. Alright, we'll leave this track on. This is not bad, I guess. Alright. Let's see where that has gone to now. Show in folder. Alright, yes, here we go. Documents. No. I'm gonna cut that. Sorry, you guys can't see what I'm doing. I'm just moving it into the maps folder. So we've got the nighttime one ready to go. Tampa looks like it's gonna take a while. So we're gonna leave Tampa for now. But let's jump back over to Skate XL and go to maps. There it is. It's cool that it's live. I don't have to like log out, log back into the game. It just loads it straight in. Come on. Oh, I guess it is a big file. Must be taking one. Oh, there it is. Oh, lighting looked good. It doesn't have the same sort of lighting you would see in like a AAA title, but that's, I guess this must be the mod creator lighting, which is, it's still really good though. Yeah, anyone who's played around with, you know, Unreal Engine or Unity or anything like that, you know that to set up the lighting like this with the shadowing, it's in itself is it's a bit of a task, like setting the right amount of luminescence, like to get that to go to here in lighting, but then be somewhat realistic is quite difficult. And the shadowing is pretty good too. Not just getting the light there, is then making sure the shadowing is working as it should. We forgot the floor. And now I can't get back. Oh, I cannot get back. Wait, is this where I'm going to go? Yeah. I'm not meant to be here.
This is
outside the map. And it's like glitching as I'm trying to get back in. There we go. That's it. Just had to go a bit higher. One of the things that is frustrating me a little bit about the controls is when you like in the trick position, you can't turn. I'm like, you have to use the triggers to do the turning, And my natural instinct is not to use the triggers. I want to use the joystick. As you do in most games. Most games you're going to use that. It's kind of like... Well, did not latch that wrap. It's kind of like in some games where you get into like a plane and the controls are using to turn the plane is to use the triggers. But your first instinct is always to try and use the thumbsticks. So, analog sticks, that's the one. I like this map though. It'd be really like interesting to know if they did something like L.A. Noir. L.A. Noir, for those who don't know, is a game made by Rockstar, similar to like your Grand Theft Autos, except it was set in like, I think it was like the 30s or 40s or something. And you were a police officer, but when they were developing the game, you could submit your own ideas for buildings, and I think like anything really, like characters and everything. It was very like to get, I guess, some buzz for the game. A lot of community driven content was made, and they used some people's buildings and stuff in the games, and they would be credited at the end. So Rockstar, I know one of my brother's friends actually submitted a building which ended up being used in the game, and Rockstar just credit the people, I guess. So I'm wondering how much content they use for that one. But games like this map here, this little section of a map is actually pretty cool. It's got good setup for lines. Like, it needs a bit of work to work out the where the walls are and stuff. But besides that, this map area shows a lot of promise. So, Pactol. If that's the right pronunciation, Pactol, you've done a good job. I really like this map, actually. I kind of want to get myself set up to do a line or something, but I don't know where to go. I'm going to try and get up here, and I'm going to do a set down the stairs across, and then finish off across the road. Here we go. Okay, I've got a little ramp here. That's good. All right. So we're trying. We're gonna do some sort of grind down that rail, and then we'll work it out when we get there. All right, we need to keep our reset set to here, basically there. Didn't really grind. This map doesn't really have the walls. I don't know what the part of the software would be, but it doesn't seem to register a lot of the rail as a rail. That's fine. It's still in development. I guess this is just a setup. Let's go check if Tampa has finished though. Really want to get on Tampa. No, not really. Oh, it's almost done. It is almost done. No. Ah, it's not the green bar down the bottom. Let's see if there's any other maps in that Discord. Oh, that's cool. Ooh. 7 files and 3 subfolders. I don't know. That looked cool though. This one here's got some interesting advertisement. I guess that's meant to be Stella Artois. There's a beer company. Is that like a mod pack? So you, like things you can put in your worlds? Okay. Ooh. This one's like a proper skate park. I like this. What's this? It's a Google Drive. I like Google Drives. I'll download this one too. Oh, megabytes. What? That can't be right. The other ones are like... Oh, no, they are megabytes. Huh. Okay. Let's get it. It's taking a while to download that one from the... What is it, a media fire or something? Like, in comparison, we're already up to 15 megabytes on PDA Seville. So, we are getting a lot through a lot faster on the Google Drive ones. It just must be the hosting, I guess. They must boost it or something. Interesting, interesting. That's some sick height. See this here, this attention to detail is really awesome. When games like, it might seem something small, but to just build that with a texture, and that texture be in-game, not just like an overlay, like in some games where it's just like a 2D texture, but when it's a 3D texture that actually has the sort of, I guess, the grooves and stuff, that is really good, like, hard work. And you know that's taken them a while to get those grooves and everything. Wow, that's a big one. I wonder if those, if there's any alleys or anything behind those. Like, have they taken that kind of detail, level detail, I should say? That's a pretty basic one. I think they've gone for more the functionality, not the aesthetics. But I think that'll give you a good opportunity to do some lines along that ledge. This is actually a lot of work from all these people. This is really cool. Ooh, that one looks cool. Oh, that's a Raphael. Don't know Raphael. Couldn't preview the file. Nah, I don't trust it already. Alright. Okay. I think we've got a good amount of files here. We just gotta wait for the Tampa one, and fuck that. The Tampa one has taken ages. Alright, let's get back to this one. I wanna try and get a good line set up on this first. Staircase. Alright, so I think I'm going to set up my line. So I'm definitely going to start my line up here on these stairs, because I think this is a good setup. Oh, this one's a bit more open. I'll set them up here. And then we're going to come across. We're going to go up the ramp. No, we're not. No, we'll come across here. Go up this ramp. Then come down here. I'm going to try and do some flip trick down here. There's a bowl here. Okay, we'll go in there after. Then we go down here. and then we're gonna try and grind the entire rail, come off, and then that'll be the end of it. Okay. Didn't connect, but okay. That's all right. We don't need to worry about. Oh no! Ruined. It's funny though when they don't connect and there's the animation that happens. Ah, I'm not getting the speed. Okay, I need to get the speed. Nah, it's good enough. You can do this. Come on, come on. Oh no! Hit it too hard. Alright, fall. Alright. Come on, come on. Do a big trick. No! Fuck. Good. There needs to be a reset button. There probably is, but I just haven't worked it out yet. Oh! I don't think it. I don't think it. The game knows that this is a rail because he hasn't tried to grind it at all. Oop. Okay. Yeah. That. Next time, I'll just add the ting noise myself. Perfect. A bit sketchy landing. Almost. Oh, no. I can't get the height. Tink. Bit late. Sound lag. Ah. Oh. Tink. Oh, he missed it entirely. All right. Simple pop shove it. All right, now here we go, here we go. Oh, no. Ah. Again, I tried to use the analog stick whilst in my pre-ollie stage. Okay. Tink. Perfect. Perfect. Nice little kickflip up the curb. Tink. Kind of missed it. It's alright, we'll keep going, keep going. Practice makes perfect. Oh, I keep doing that. Alright. Tink. Alright, that works, that works. He bumped off the route, but that's okay. I think it really wants you to adapt the controls to using the bump the triggers as your way to control the character. I mean, it has its merits, I guess. Ah. Tink. Okay, there we go. Doesn't matter. A little ollie. It's good. We have. Ah. Tink. All right. Here we go. Here we go. This could be it. This could be it. I'm feeling it. I'm feeling this one. Almost there. Good enough. Alright, we got the speed. Oh no, hit too hard. Damn. Good enough, I'll take it. I don't think we're gonna get this at all. I don't think it's gonna happen. Alright. We'll come back to that later. I'm gonna go check out this bowl. Okay. Why does he do that? You understand? Yeah, the bowl. The bowl, what the fuck? It's, yeah. What the hell? The programming of this. What the fuck? He just jumps straight off. He doesn't like. Here we go. Oh, yeah, okay. We come back down fine. He started on. Okay. Yeah, the mechanics for the this level are nowhere compared to the setup level. And if we go back to maps, I accidentally loaded it. Doesn't want me to get into the maps. Doesn't want me to leave. Wants me to stay forever. But I just like you. I don't love you. Come on, okay. Let's try this one more time. That's it. Yeah, so this one. So this level here, you can see straight up with the half pipe. Well, like it's, there's like a gravity to it almost. Like I'm doing an ollie there, but my character automatically lines themselves up, which it is not doing that whatsoever. In no way, shape or form the other one. So there's a bit of program there, but that is still like, as a design aesthetic, that level is really cool. You can tell a lot of work went into that one. I want to try out Tampa. Tampa's like my favorite map in all the skate games. I have it like the Tony Hawk games. Like I think there's Tampa's in a couple of them, but specifically I think Tony Hawk Pro Skater 3. I think it is that one. The Tampa on that. I think the setup of that is sick. Oop. Getting these lines set up pretty well. Oh! One of the best things in Skate is the Thrasher like mode where you just destroy yourself, try and get as many broken bones and stuff. Oh, I hope this game has that when it releases. I hope Skate 4 comes out. Jeez, that'd be sick. I think there's going to be a big influx in skate games over the next 2 years. Because there hasn't been a proper skate game in a while. And there's like a market for that. Like, I don't think it's like it can be oversaturated like the first person shooter market is. Like the Battle Royale market now is just, it's ludicrous. But skate games, I think there's enough people interested in it, like skater or non-skater. Like I used to skate as a kid, but I don't skate anymore. I haven't skated since I was like maybe 12. I can't remember, to be honest. It sounds about right, about 12, but I still appreciate it. I'd still 100% watch, you know, a skate video with pleasure. Like, no hassles at all watching 2-hour documentary on skateboarding, or just 2 hours of, you know, people doing sick lines. Like my favorite skater, I liked Ryan Scheckler, when it was back when he was like he was probably 16 to about 21 when I watched him skating. I was about the same age, so I think that's probably why I appreciated him a bit as a skater. But then Nigel Houston, I just thought he was good because he was so young, but he was already so good. And I did not even get that. And then who else? I wasn't a big fan of Rob Dyrdek. He was just a bit more of a pretty boy for TV. I didn't really think he was all that great. Which is probably why he didn't really skate too much in his show, because he wasn't really famous for his skating persona, I guess. It was just, he was famous for being a celebrity, like a Kardashian celebrity, but for skating. Who else though? I wasn't a fan of Bob Burnquist. Maybe I just didn't see enough of him. Andrew Reynolds, I liked him. Danny Way, I kind of liked his enthusiasm. Ben Margera, everyone loves Ben Margera though. I think you can't be somebody who's grown up, you know, millennial, like early millennial. You can't be an early millennial and not think Ben Margera is just funny. Jackass, you know, sweet life of Bam's on Holy Union, whatever. Like all of his shows that he had, Viva La Bam. It was just funny just watching him fuck around with his mates and his family. That's a big fakey kickflip. That's a fakey heel flip. Okay. Any stops? Alright, now let's quickly check out Tampa. Let's see if we can play that finally. Looks like the downloads are done. Sick. Show in folder. Alright, I'm going to copy these two. Cut those documents. Awesome. Nice. All right. Now let's. Oops. Here we go. Tampa. I think they're going to take a while to load, longer than the other ones, just because their size is so big. So Tampa is 433 megabytes, and that's nighttime one was 347. That took about 30 seconds itself. So this is probably going to take about 40 seconds or so to load up. Hopefully the size means the file size means the size of the map is big. Ooh, they've even got like the Monster Energy logos on this. Hang on, let's just have a quick whip around here. Like the detailing here, they've got like somebody's left their skateboard out. There's another skateboard here, the Supreme board here. Like this detailing, like who made this one? Masterflex, mate, you've done good job. This looks sick. Let's get involved. Oh. Off the bat. Hang on, does this character look like Tony Hawk? when he comes back around, next time we crash, I think he's meant to be a Tony Hawk ripoff. Nice. See this one here. They've coated the rails properly by the looks of it. Okay. Ooh, maybe not this rail. Yeah. These rails, these. Alright. You can tell the person who made this is 100% a skater. Like, they're not just like a skater enthusiast, because they've gone ahead and they've 100% been to skate park. Like, look at that. You got the Avaka. Hang on, let's get back to that. You've got, I can't even get in. So we've got the Vans, the Avaka. What's that, Mob Grip? Yeah, we need to get there on the skateboard. I can't even read those. We can. Look at that, they've even got the episode of something playing in the background there. So we've got Flip, we've got Baker, Element, Volcom, Richter. Look at that. That ES there, that's the... Who's that? Is that Bob Burnquist? Hang on. What's this image here in the back? That's like straight up just like a photograph from somebody's workshop. What the hell? What the hell is that? Hang on a second. This background image is not right. What is that? That is the great. So, they've used like some random image on their computer as the, I guess, the world image? Let's see if we can check it out in the other places of the map. Hang on, let's turn around here. Oh, there's nothing here to sort of look into. Can we get stuck in the wall hitting that? Hang on. Go this way. Ah! No, why do you want me to go this way so bad? Go this way. Oh my god. Alright, looks like we have to go this way and then we'll come back. Alright, so hopefully now we should be able to just climb up here. Oop, don't fall. Okay. Hopefully in the game you'll be able to run around instead of just being stuck to the board. Can we see through this door? Yeah, we can see through this door. Not that this has any sort of like... it's not like a bad thing. Like, this is, it's expected from like this style of community sort of built things. Like, they haven't got the time, I guess, to bother with this stuff. This, if this was in a professional game, like a AAA title, you would be like, what the fuck? But with being in like somebody's custom like one is absolutely fine. It's just funny, the image that it is just like some random workshop. Which I guess kind of suits, like... I've never been to the Tampa place, but look, you can tell you're in a warehouse of sorts. So if you were to, like, bust through that wall, I would expect to see some other, like, warehouse-esque setup and a mechanics workshop is that. So, I mean, whether it's intentional or not, you know, it's Master Flex. If that was intentional, props to you for that. It was a happy accident. Works out. I don't think I have the expertise. I think this is the prime reason why I would never go to Tampa, the Tampa AM or anything like that, because I do not have the skill virtually or in real life to compete on this field. So let's go check out the last one. What's this? PDA Savelle. I think this is made by Mario Mr. TSNZ, so maybe New Zealand. But yeah, it's the first one. I'm really enjoying these like community build ones. A lot of work's gone into these, like hours. Especially with that one just now with the stickers and everything. Let's have a quick whip around the map. So we've got a bit of a beach or a river. I imagine this grass doesn't have any sort of, I guess, ground to it. So I think we'd just fall straight through the map on that one by the standard we've seen so far. This is interesting. That actually might be good to set up. So if you get some speed, I guess you'd automatically, without having to do an ollie, you'd make that gap. Then you could hit that, and then I guess the idea is to hit the rail. Okay. Oh, here's the bowl there. This is why we've got it over here, because the bowl. Oh, this looks sick. What's this? I guess we're gonna try and do like a roll over the top of that. Okay. What's this? Some statue? We can go up, hold down R. Don't go that high. Okay. I think our first thing I want to try is this. So I'm going to set up my marker over here. Ooh, there's another little skate park over here. I'm going to set up my marker here. I think this is good. Okay. Oh, I didn't fall. No! Alright, there we go. So, okay, so I need to angle myself a little bit, and then we can hit this. No, not hitting it there. Alright. Angle a bit more. Oh! Okay. Ah! Okay. He's actually not getting the speed that I needed, so I'm not sure if we're going to do this. Here we go. Oh! Okay. Let's do this. We do it this time. We're not going to try and do a trick or anything. We're just going to hit it. Oh, didn't mean to kick it then. Okay. Oh, it's not even a rail that you meant to slide. No. Okay. Let's go over to that quarter pipe. Actually, let's check out the wall here. Is this just they intended to build more over here? Can I go through that? No. Pop shove it down whatever 12 set. Sick. Oh. He's not grabbing the, they won't grab the board though. I don't know if I'm doing something wrong there, but he won't grab the board. Oop. Okay, let's head straight over there. Set us up. 4. Alright. Let's try and do this. This is unusual. So he didn't register the... It's like, once he's hit that, it's like messing it up. Can he hit it? Oh, almost got the grass. Oh, actually the grass does exist as a surface. What haven't been able to do? That's what we want to do. Let's see if we can do it here. Got it. Cool. Alright, so let's see if we can shred this skate park. Definitely the controls in this game are going to take a bit of getting used to. I'm still using the left thumbstick as my ability to turn. And I know the game doesn't want me to do that. It wants me to use their triggers to do so. But just instinctually, I just don't want to do that. Like in that split second when you need to make that turn, my instinct is straight away to thumbstick. I don't think it registered that as a grind then. Alright. I think that's going to be it for today, guys. We've tried out a few good maps here. I think there's lots and lots of potential with this game. I'm excited for it to come out in about a month's time. I'm going to continue to play this and try some more of the community maps a bit later on. So please feel free to tune back in. Don't forget to follow on Twitch. We've got Twitch live running at the moment, so feel free to jump over there anytime. Subscribe if you're watching this on YouTube, and I'll see you next time.